GrokTALK.
This is a coalition of New Hampshire taxpayers. We're located at 8 North Main in Concord, New Hampshire. This is the repository for all things conservative and municipal. So if you have a problem in your town, your school, your budget committee, the right to know law, and now at the top of our list is voter fraud. You have a tip for us, some information for us, you want to join or help us out, cnht.org.
Three, two, one.
We'd like to welcome you to another edition of GrokTALK, brought to you by New Hampshire's leading conservative blog site, GraniteGrok.com. We are your feared, extremist, right-wing, hard-charging, gun-toting, opinionated, outspoken, rabble-rousing, letter-writing, radio, microphone-stomping conservatives and rational libertarians. So get ready for more news and opinion you could only get from GraniteGrok.com.
GrokTALK.
All right, there's a big midterm election just a few days away. We are GrokTALK. I'm Steve McDonald here with Skip Murphy from Concord, New Hampshire, the first in the nation primary state, something that'll matter a lot more in the next 2 years. But for now, we're going to focus on some local stuff. And, of course, there's a national Senate race going on here that's gotten a lot of attention. And we're going to talk about our Whiskey Tango Foxtrot of the Week. Somebody local who has become a national celebrity.
That would be you, Mr. Pindell.
James.
James Pindell. Pindell. I always say Pindell.
I always say Pindell, too. Is it Pindell?
Pindell.
He pronounces it Pindell?
I think so.
Okay, well, we want to pronounce it the way he pronounces it.
It's James.
Yes, well, James. James Pindell. James Pindell.
It's really bad when MSNBC decides to whack you.
Yeah.
Calls you a little guy.
That is kind of mean. And that is mean. That's mean. You know, I mean, yeah, he did something stupid. Yeah, he looked like he was a drug mule for the Democrat Party narrative.
Drug mule?
Absolutely looked like that.
Drug mule.
Absolutely, yeah.
Oh, gosh, and that goes way past my four-letter word
right?
for him
and,
last night.
It's just what it looks like. But a little guy, all right, that's mean.
Having that little guy just sort of ask that same little question over and over again like that, and he was just trying to be so smart.
Didn't work out so well.
No. Does this mean that he's no Candy Crowley?
Maybe. Yeah, she was kind of smart, wasn't she? What did I write? I wrote something this morning or last night about that. Where is it? Here it is.
Yep.
Oof, it's got to be bad when even MSB.
That's mine.
I can't even say it. All right. Anyway, later today, this morning, actually shortly, Pete Ingemi will be joining us, the Tech Guy radio host down in Massachusetts. We're going to take 15 minutes to talk about some election stuff. And then we're going to freelance it for a bit because we don't have a 9:30 guest. Our 9:30 guest had to cancel on account of some campaigning thing that they were doing. And then after
imagine
that.
Imagine that.
We will have, yeah, imagine that campaigning. And after that, we will have Darlene Pawlik from New Hampshire Right to Life here. I'm assuming she's going to be here. I didn't book her, but okay. And then maybe Emily O'Neill, who's running as a write-in candidate for in Bedford, I believe, as a Republican. And hopefully she'll be here. If not, we'll just keep doing what we do, which is talk about the stuff that we talk about. And we can fill space. Here it is. What did I write? Now that it's a national story, this is the Pindell thing on the bottom of Skip's post. Plenty of folks will know Brown was more or less right, a lot more than would have ever suspected because of Pindell that he might be wrong. One of the initial things was they said, well, this is clearly a hit because the people who watched the debate saw Pindell try to embarrass him. And whether or not they're familiar with where Sullivan County is, and I made the point on Twitter, most people in New Hampshire have no clue where Sullivan County is, except people who live in Sullivan County. And somebody else said there's people in Sullivan County. They don't know they live in Sullivan County. So I was like, well, okay, fine. You know, maybe they just don't think about it that way.
Well, can you name all 10 counties in New Hampshire?
No.
Being the political blogger that we are.
Oh, I know where. I know Coos, Carroll, Belknap, Rockingham, Hillsborough, Sullivan.
Oh, there's seven.
I don't know I know the names of the three. I can't think of what they are. It's like naming dwarves. You know, you always miss one.
Dwarves. Well, here in New Hampshire, being, you know, we're a state that's...
And that's the only reason I know those names.
Yeah.
Coos is obvious, because if you've ever been up north, Kuwa. You're like, you say it wrong first.
Koas.
Koas, right. I even say it wrong now, even though I know it's not Koos.
Yes, okay. C-O-O-S,
yes.
Koas.
Koas. And so, you know, most people don't have a clue. I mean, I asked a bunch of people at work. They don't know. I asked nobody in my house had a clue where Sullivan County was. It's like, why would I know where that is?
Maybe I should stop at Tanger Outlet, bring the recording camera, and just ask that same question.
Yeah.
Are you from New Hampshire? Yes. Do you know where Sullivan County is? Do you even know who's running for U.S. Senator?
Mm.
I keep forgetting that we have a... I
got to wonder
large...
if they know who the governor is.
Yeah.
Yes, we do have a above average annual income, but they're still low information voters. Yes.
Well, you know, to their credit, though, I think they're still operating under the old model of government really should be 4, 5, 6, 7 levels down from your daily life.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sorry, but I like Rick Perry's phrase when he started to run for president, you know, 4 years ago. My job is to make Washington, D.C. as inconsequential to your daily life as possible. And really, government should be inconsequential. It should have very little to do with your ordinary life and the choices you can make. And unfortunately, progressives always have loved that phrase from Cicero. You may not be interested in politics, but be sure politics is interested in you. They always say the political is personal, the personal is political. So ask yourself, what area of your life can you delve into without government peeking under the curtain or busting down the door? Take your pick. And that's because of progressives. Progressives believe, and it was very clear watching the first congressional district race debate, that Carol Shea Porter believes that the only answer that is a good answer is one that has the word government in it. Every single time a problem was brought up, well, we ought to have a program. We ought to have a program. Well, we need to fund this program. We need to do that program. It's like, you know something? What? Here I go. I almost had my own WTF moment. Skip having a meltdown. Really, what makes you believe that government workers, elected, appointed, or just employees, are all that much smarter than the rest of us outside, that they should be telling us how to live our lives? It's not like they're genuine geniuses.
Yeah, no kidding.
You know,
well, you know, it's the it's like Bastiat said, what makes legislators who are just from the common people voted for by... Somebody's phone just buzzed. I think it was yours.
I think it was mine.
The common people, any smarter or more brilliant than those same people, you know?
I got a text from you.
A text? I didn't think you could get texts.
Well, I'm not. I can receive. I'm not supposed to be doing anything.
It might have been a text from like 6 months ago.
Well, I'll look at it later. I'll silence this for now.
Bzz, bzz.
Yeah. So now that's exactly what it just did.
Yeah. Bzz, bzz.
Now, here's something. Jeffrey Singer, Obamacare's Medicaid expansion limits medical choices. Isn't that what government does? That's from Instapundit right now. Government limits choices. It has to. In order for government to work, according to progressives, we must make the choices for you. And I'm certainly seeing the choices in the insurances that I'm being offered at work.
Choices. You can choose to pay more, or pay more.
No, extremely more.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, add all the adjectives and whatever you want. So.
I just get, it's sort of like life's one big thing of, you know, that moveon.org contest that they're doing about changing the rules. Well, a conservative group put in a movie that, you know, Move On said, we'll pay lots of bucks for the winning movie. We'll make a commercial out of it.
Oh, yeah. I remember
so
this.
So I think it was.
Posted something.
Yeah. And the May Day contest went in. Well, the CEI group, conservative, I think it was the CEI group, folks, think tank, did a wonderful video. Lots of people were voting for it. They came in number one.
Mm-hmm.
How dare those conservatives pick up a camera? So MoveOn decided, we can't have this. We can't let the conservatives win. They changed the rules, and then they won again. And it just keeps on going. In other words, if they can't win by the rules they set, they have no problems in saying, we'll change the rules once again. They can't let conservatives win.
You want to give me this camera for a second?
Which
the
camera?
The one right in front of me.
Oh, that camera.
I just got a multimedia message from George Lambert. Got if you can see this.
A whole...
This picture, I don't know if you can see it or not. This is
real
what,
close.
This is in front of George Lambert's house. They took all his signs down.
Pull it back. Pull it back just a little.
I can see the camera.
Yeah, you're glinting. Yeah.
You do it.
Let me.
You.
Let me.
So they all his signs are down and thrown around, and there's a Donna Susie sign there. I can't see it anymore. It's kind of gone all glary. Anyway, and now it's dark.
That's why. You can see the Eye of Sauron.
Let's try it again. See if you can see that. Anyway, you see all that stuff on the ground? Those are his signs. You see that one red sign? That's a Donna Susie sign. That's what the Democrats did last night at his house. Happy Halloween. So I'm sorry. Please continue.
Well,
did I derail your train of thought?
No, it actually just a slight side rail to it, because it shows that if the progressives can't win by the rules, they have no problems in flouting the rules. In the case of Move On and that video contest they put on, they changed the rules to rig the game. Here, it shows that the Democrats can't win by normal means, so they will break all the rules. This is sort of like the Mr. Betty Lasky work-alike from Maryland.
I love that picture.
That was a great picture. But
thanks to whoever sent it to me originally. I don't even remember, but it was so awesome.
Yeah. I mean, and that's the first thing I thought of when I saw that guy. The video that they took of this guy, husband of yet another state senator, ripping down the Republican paid-for signs and then denying everything. All I could do was think of
he claimed emotional distress, and the police were like, oh, okay.
Well that's – and that was the other parallel.
Your phone's buzzing again.
That was the other parallel. Both Mr. Betty Lasky and this husband of this other female state senator running in Maryland both said, well, I'm frustrated with the how this race is going. I get frustrated all the time. I don't go ripping up other people's property and taking it away. I don't. I value the rule or the right to private property. I don't destroy other people's stuff just because I don't like them.
Correct.
And that's the point.
It is exactly the point. And it's. And I think that
if you can't win by the rules, don't play the game.
Well, they don't follow the rules. They don't. It's like the Pindell thing. Like I tweeted. Nice job, by the way. You were a tweeting animal that night. Army of Shaheen out-of-state voters won't know where Sullivan County is, even if they steal a vote there.
Well, you know what's come up in the on the blogosphere. You've seen it just as much as I have. All of a sudden, all these voter fraud stories are coming up, and it's only because organizations like CNHT, Ed Nail, Chair.
I did invite him if he was around, but I haven't heard back.
Yeah, but you know, a lot of other groups have said, you know, we're finding the same thing, and now you're hearing of hundreds of stories coming up with thousands of voter fraud. Maryland itself has, in one county, 1,400 illegal voters, illegal alien voters. You know that James O'Keefe thing has made another campaign manager quit. You know where he sent in his...
Yeah, I posted that video.
Yeah, you did. And, you know, you look at that. You know what struck me? It wasn't just the Democrats. It was also the Republican campaign chair that was said, as long as you have your voter registration card, you're good. In other words, what they were saying was, it doesn't matter that it's against the law because you're illegal alien at the 50,000-foot level. All they care about is at the one-inch level. You got that voter registration card, which she admits as part of the spiel. I got it by mistake. I should not have this. And they said, go ahead and vote. You want Kay Hagan to win? You want to vote for her? Go ahead. But it was judge and sheriff and assistant judge and this and that. Everybody having to do with the upholding of the rule of law. They're all saying, go ahead, break the law as long as you're going to vote for me. You know, I've been getting more depressed over the last couple of weeks. Again, now we go back to the dense pack stuff we were talking about.
It's the pre-election depression. Hey, you know, you can talk about it with Pete because we have to call him now. So we're going to take a quick break. Skip's going to call Pete. We'll be right back. Pete and Jimmy, the Tech Guy. Stay tuned.
What if your take-home pay went down 25%? Where would you cut back? What would you do without?